हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम एम राजू, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ इंग्लिश वर्किंग फॉर विट्स वरंगल. वेलकम टू विट्स कनेक्ट. इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट वर्ड्स ऑफ एंड कन्फ्यूज्ड. वर्ड्स ऑफ एंड कन्फ्यूज्ड आई ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट हाउ द वर्ड्स इज फ्रेम्ड एंड देर आर सम डिफरेंट इन द स्पेलिंग्स बट साउंड्स वेरी सिमिलर. देर इज सम डिफरेंस इन स्पेलिंग, इट साउंड्स वेरी सिमिलर. दिस इज कॉल्ड वर्ड्स ऑफ एंड कन्फ्यूज्ड. I hope you done it some, I've given assignment for you. I hope you, we're all done it at home and better to put it in a Wits Connect app, in a assignments app. Today, let's we talk about basic sentence structures. Topic number 10, basic sentence structure. What do you mean by basic sentence structure? Sentence information is the most important thing in English and communication language. Why? Because Without sentence form, we could not frame a sentence, we could not speak in a fluent English. What are the sentences in English? For example, if you want to speak something, if you want to write something, we need a subject. Here, what do you mean by subject? The parts of the sentence. We are looking for the definition, parts of the sentence. What do you mean by parts? There is a subject. Subject, the person or thing that does something. What do you mean by subject? The person or thing that does something. What do you mean by subject? You can call, for example, I am Raju, I am a subject. Subject, it very important thing in a framing sentence. The does something to the gives the full manner. And also coming to the verb. What do you mean by verb? Verb is the heart of the sentence. Without verb, we cannot frame a single sentence. Without verb, we cannot frame a single sentence. A word that expresses an action, occurrence, or state of being. For example, chudandi. Without verb, for example, I am eating. In that, eating is a verb. Eating is a verb. Without eating, I am. What do you mean by I am? I am is a subject. But without verb, we cannot frame a full-fledged sentence. Without frame a full-fledged sentence. Here, the next one is object. A person or thing that receives the action of a verb. It is and also called the receiver. You can call also, object is a the receiver. The object receives the action is called the receiver. Why we called object receiver? Because it take all the responsible of what the frame subject and verb. Here coming to the word order. How the word order is framed in English. For example, here the subject, here the verb, here the object. For example, he reads books. Here the word order, he is a subject. Reads is a verb, and books is an object. These are the most important things to frame any kind of sentences. Subject, verb, and object played an important role while framing a sentences. Sometimes we may frame without object. We can frame with the help of subject and verb. Coming to the next example, John drove a car. Here the John is a subject, he is a person. And also drove is a V3 form, drive, drove. And also he is an object. What is the object? The receives a car. John drove a car. If you want to frame any sentence, we require three things. What is subject and verb and object? Okay, student, coming to the basic sentence structure in English. Sometimes we may frame without object. How it is possible? Here is the example. In English, there are some principles are there. There are some structures. Here we can frame without object. If we want to frame any sentence, we need a subject, verb plus object. We discussed in the first topic. And here we can frame without object. Subject plus verb. Here I am giving an example. He reads. He is the subject. Reads is the verb. Here, dogs bark. Here is the dogs is the subject.
bark is the verb. Bark is the verb. She cries. She cries. She is the subject. Cries is the verb. Here, sometimes we can frame without object. Without object. Here, coming to the number second structure. Subject plus verb plus object. If one frame any sentence, we need require subject, verb plus verb. Subject, verb plus object. Here, I like X. I like X. I is a subject. Like is the verb. X is the object. X is the object. He is reading a book. He is reading a book. In that, he is the subject. Is reading is the verb. A book is the object. A book is the object. She studies science. She studies science. Here, she is the subject. Studies is the verb. Science is the object. These are the two structures. Subject plus verb. Subject plus verb plus object. Here, coming to the number third structure. Subject plus verb plus subject complement. Subject plus verb plus SC means subject complement. Subject complement. Here is the subject complement. Always talking about the specialty of a subject. The specialty of a subject is called subject complement. Subject complement is called, it speaks about the specialty of a subject. What the subject is done. What the subject is done. Here example. He is a soldier. He is a soldier. He is a subject. He is the helping verb. And a soldier is a subject complement. Means SC. Here is the. He is a soldier means. Who is a soldier? He. Sometimes you can write a person's name. For example, Ramesh is a soldier. Here you can understand. Soldier. How the subject complement is talking about? The subject complement talking about subject. The specialty of who is a soldier? He is a particular person. The subject complement always talking about the specialty of a subject is called subject complement. Is called subject complement. The sky is blue. The sky is blue. The sky is subject. Is the helping verb. And blue is the SC, subject complement. Who is blue is here? The sky, the subject complement. And my cousin became an actor. My cousin became an actor. Here is the my cousin, subject. And became is a verb. And an actor is the subject complement. Actor is the subject complement. The subject complement talking about who is my cousin. The specialty of my cousin is called subject complement. Here the fourth one. Subject plus verb plus object complement. What do you mean by object complement? The object complement always talking about the specialty of object. The specialty of object. The magician made the child very happy. The magician is a subject. Made is a verb. The child is an object. And very happy is a object complement. The object complement always speaks about and talks about the specialty of a object. The magician made the child very happy. Is called a subject plus verb plus object complement. Okay, students, here is the another structure. Subject plus verb plus IO plus DO means indirect object plus direct object. Subject plus verb plus indirect object plus direct object. Here I am giving the example. My father bought me a pen. My father bought me a pen. Here the subject is my father. Bought is a verb. Me is an indirect object. Direct object is a pen. Here I gave her books. I gave her books. Raju taught me English. Raju taught me English. Here they can understand subject plus verb plus indirect object plus direct object. These are the five structures very most important in our basic sentence structures. Okay, student, coming to the number six. the basic sentence structure: subject plus verb plus adjective. We all know very well about the adjective. What do you mean adjective? Adjective describe something specialty about a particular, whatever it may be. Here then, in adjective we can observe the quality, quantity, color, taste and size and numbers. We all know better about it. Here the subject plus verb plus adjective plus adjective. Here the example: he is smart. He is smart. He is a subject, is a verb, and smart is a adjective. Here the smart is a adjective. Coming to the next one: the flowers are red. The flowers are red. Here is the flowers. Subject are is a verb, helping verb, and red is a adjective. Here the red means the color. We can describe adjective also. We talk about the color, taste, size, quality, quantity. You can understand that what you mean red is here the adjective. Here subject plus verb plus adjective is called he is smart and the flowers are red. Coming to the last one: subject plus verb plus object plus adjunct. Plus adjunct. What do you mean adjunct? It's an optional one. You can take as a secondary element. It is a in a sentence. You can take as a secondary element, not for a first one. You can choose where it is applicable or not. We may choose. If the first one is not available, you can choose the adjunct, means the second one, the optional one. We can call in a sentence, font frame, something. We can choose adjunct means as a optional, as a supplementary element, as a second option. We can use subject plus verb plus object plus adjunct means the secondary option. You can choose, for example, if the person is available, we can choose the first person. Otherwise, we can take the without this option, we can take the second person. We can choose the adjunct is a secondary option, is a optional secondary option and available, which is we can take. The doctor treated me for toothache. Here the example: the doctor, subject, treated is a verb, and me is object, for toothache is a adjunct. What may take? Is there some pain in teeth? Some pain in teeth. We can consider a dentist. If I was any place, very important. Teeth are very most important. If you get any pain, small pain, we may consult the dentist. Here, the doctor treated me for toothache. Is the adjunct? Is the optional? Here, a scientist conduct experiments in the library. A scientist conducts experiments in the library. Here is a scientist is a subject, conduct is a verb, experiments in the object, in the library is adjunct. Here this is about a basic sentence structure. I hope you will understand. Thank you very much for joining.